Welcome to the 2018 recap video from an old empty workspace. A bit late, usually these things happen in December. Now it's already January. I know. I do think I have a good reason why I'm late, but you'll see that at the end of this video. But for now, let's rewind back to the beginning. This year started off kind of chill. I didn't have that much on my schedule. Not really a clue what the year would bring. But there was one thing to do, setting up a precious plastic workspace with Mattia and Joey in Chile, in the beautiful area in Patagonia.
Epic!
And while I was there, I also traveled up north in the desert to visit the lithium mine. Learning about this resource, I made a video about electric cars. Back home, I actually made a few more story hoppers. I'm not sure why I do these things. The topics are just in my head and I need to... Anyway, I also made one with Lieke about straws. Okay, so little side note here, which I actually never mentioned. So honestly, it feels very weird to talk about this because it's private. But it also feels weird to not talk about it because you've seen me and Lieke, you know, traveling together, setting up our own vegetable garden or raising a chicken. Life of a YouTuber, I guess. Anyway, so basically we are not a couple anymore. We have been together for 8 years. Very long time. We basically grew up together. All the things we did, I mean, we're very much part of each other's life. But at some point we did a big trip in Asia. And when we came back, we were kind of wondering, are we still together because we want to, or just because we are and we're used to it? So more as a little experiment, we decided to break up. And if we come back together, we probably do it because we want to and not just because we are. So we did that, but actually never came back together as a couple. So we're still very much close friends. We still do a lot of things together. I still feel very much like she's my best friend, but we're just not a couple anymore. And I guess it's okay. Weird sometimes, sometimes also nice. And this actually happened last year, but I didn't mention because it felt weird. But so here you go. I hope it clears things up. Anyway, because we broke up, I didn't have a house anymore. And I also didn't want to rent the house. So last year I actually lived here in the workspace in a small little bed. And it's not legal to live here. So every morning I folded my bed back up and in the evening I took it down. So it was very hidden and no one could see it. It was fun. But after a year, I liked a bit more privacy. So this year I actually bought an old German ambulance van and turned it into a little house. And it's actually also preparation for this bigger project, Project Comp, which is about building our own house in a piece of land somewhere. So it's a good starting point to be mobile, so you can just drive there and sleep for a while until everything is figured out. And halfway in the year, we had a few unexpected twists. First, the local government had an empty building and asked if we wanted to use it for free for 1 year. That's cool. Then we won a 300,000 euro award. That's also cool.
Congratulations.
Thanks.
And we gathered a big to-do list for Precious Plastic version 4. I figured maybe we should do something here. So I took the van, the house, to Portugal to make a plan for our next move.
Currently in Tabeira, on a parking space. Mattia is doing something. Yeah, cleaning.
Good morning. Good
morning. And we just...
Exactly. Launched.
We just launched version 4.
It's beautiful.
Gonna be chaos from now?
Yeah.
Just launched it from the van, which was the first launch from the van.
Yeah, I guess so.
Yeah, man.
That worked pretty good. And so. Now it's time to do some other stuff.
Yes, I'm scared.
Same.
And since we're there, we also visited Tamera, a big community in the south. Honestly, the most inspiring place I've seen in years. It's too much to talk about in this video, so I'll make a more in-depth one about it later. So, back home, we gathered a team of 40 people from all over the world that came to help us out. And together, we transformed this old empty building in our new workspace. Meanwhile, my motorbike got stolen by an idiot, so I got it back. Precious Plastic in Russia showed Putin some recycling. We threw 30,000 bottles in a river for an exhibition. And we did a big exhibition in our own workspace, which is actually a good moment for people to drop by.
Yo, what's up? We're at the Precious Plastic headquarters right now with my main man. You already know what it is. This is actually a really cool space. It's actually really awesome. A lot of cool things coming. Boom!
But what is most inspiring is guys like this, Jivan from Ukraine. He's been working on this project for years. One of the first ones to get started, making these beautiful bowls with his extrusion machine. He does it way better than I could. He really took the project and improved it, and now it's his job. And it's guys like this that make this community powerful, working together on plastic waste. Thank you very much for inspiring me, Jivan. Now the team is working here every day. We're developing a robot to sort plastic, making a big press to make sheets, and a bigger version of the shredder, plus 1,000 other things. And that's the reason this video is late.
I'm not used to working with this many people. Usually I work on my own and it takes quite some time to manage this. I mean, it's fun, but yeah, I definitely need to start planning better.
But I like that this actually feels like a test run for Project Camp. Cooking and living together and meanwhile develop projects. And the deadline for version 4 is ready this October. It's a real one because we need to be out of this building. So this is now my old workspace, completely empty. And it feels a bit weird to be here. I mean, this is where everything started after my graduation. Foam blocks, fresh plastic, story hoppers. Spend a lot of time in this building. I like this place in a way I don't want to leave. And that's probably the most difficult thing of always moving forward, that you have to leave things behind that you might actually like. Anyway, a lot of new exciting things to happen though. So we'll see you next year. Actually, not because it's already next year, because I'm late. And thank you very much for supporting on Patreon. That is still just incredible. Thank you, and we'll see you on the next YouTube video.